You're way too beautiful, girl. This fight will never work. You made me suicidal. Suicidal, just to say it's over.
Sorry.
I don't know.
How you doing?
Hey.
Hello. What does it say about us that you picked this spot? Are we seem like nerds like this?
Cole picked this spot.
I picked it.
How long is the documentary tonight?
It's like 55 minutes.
Who did the editing?
Me.
Wow.
We just tried. Basically, it's about, we were making this album. All right, I'll give the whole backstory. Like, we were signed to a major label, and we signed a 1+2 deal. So we made the first album with them, and then we had the next album that we could make, and they would decide whether they wanted to keep it or not. And so you watch us as we try to finish the album to turn it into the label. And we, like, gave ourselves a deadline, so we had 1 month to finish it. And it's just all different moments from that process mixed in with just like the pressure that we felt from that. And spoiler, actually, I almost
stop. Who do you think's gonna get married first out of all you guys?
Oh, I feel like we always say always joke at HP.
I don't know if there's any reason. I'm just a lover.
Look at him. There's a reason. It's
definitely. It could go. It's kind of a coin toss right now, though. It could happen.
I think Jude.
I could see Jude.
We'll see. I don't have plans yet.
I'm gonna put my money on him. That's why I thought.
I kind of want a kid.
Pre-marriage?
Yeah, before?
Yeah. Like shotgun wedding?
Not necessarily, but I think about it sometimes.
You guys have fun
there? Yeah. Right.
Hey, how are you?
That's a good question.
Hey, buddy. That's funny.
Do you guys think about selling out?
I don't even know. Like the concept of selling out or like selling out the show?
Selling out concept.
I think it sort of works itself out in the end. It's like, if you sell out and you get attention and then you don't have anything to like back it up, then it'll, like, the internet will do what it does and just kind of like move on. But the people who have like done so much, like I was thinking about Donald Glover and how like he wouldn't be where he was today without doing Community, like the very first thing he did. And it's like build that reputation off of that. Like, I think you have to be able, even if you sell out, to sell out in multiple different areas in order to then make a like life for yourself.
And you realize how like many tiers there are to celebrity. Like, I was randomly in Las Vegas with my family and I was walking past the Madame Tussauds store, like the wax figures, you know? And like, there's like video ads on it of like Jack Harlow. And you're just like, to be that kind of like face of like this celebrity thing is like, there's just so many levels to it. But at the same time, like, Jay-Z is not going to shoot a video for that. So, you know what I mean? And it's just like, but you're so right about like Donald Glover and stuff. Like, you kind of have to climb up the ladder. And then the goal is to kind of be able to reset and just be able to do whatever you want again, you know?
We remember those shows that we went on our first tour and played for like 30 people in every city, you know? And like, they have now shown up to everything. So the dream is to like take all those kids and like put it backstage at like MSG, because that's only like 30 kids.
Yeah, we played at San Diego in San Diego last night, and there was this girl that came up to us like, I've been to every San Diego show you've ever played, and like listed them out, and it was just like, that's fucking crazy. It's like awesome. just coming back every time and like seeing the journey unfold, and like this was the biggest show we played in San Diego last night, you know, and it's just like, it's gonna keep going and she'll keep coming back.
When you guys did the tour, who was driving?
All of us.
Well, you took turns.
Yeah, we're road dogs.
So
drive it out. Henry drove the most. We kept track. Henry drove the most. What was it, like 68 hours? Here's
what I found.
68.
It's insane.
I think
it's like 3 days.
It was crazy. It was crazy.
It's gone.
We're still so young that like, and because it's still four of us, like we're still so excited by everything. Like yesterday we got to our dressing room and they had sandwiches for us, and they weren't even on our rider, but we were like, oh my god, this is so awesome. They got us sandwiches.
It has bacon in it.
Yeah, exactly.
I always wonder if like Olivia Rodrigo getting off stage and it's just her. Like, I don't know. Just getting all that attention to yourself and then just being alone. Like, I feel that we just enjoy it together and we can talk, yo, did you meet this person? Yo, I took a picture. Oh, this person smelled like ass. Like, whatever.
Did you want to invite Drake?
Nah. We've been trying to FaceTime him, but it always goes like direct to, like on Instagram, like it goes direct to hang up, like right away. Like, I think he has it turned off.
So, and you can see that, like, we tried to call him, too.
Yeah, it's so embarrassing.
Yeah, we talked to him a few days ago, but it started, we just noticed he followed us on Instagram, just completely out of nowhere. And we just, like, all, like, hyperventilated. We were just going crazy.
He was, like, texting a middle school crush.
Yeah, we were all on FaceTime.
Say that. No,
yeah,
say that.
We were drafting the text together. It was crazy. So we had this whole back and forth with him. He was, like, giving us love. Like, the first message he sent was, like, Crazy Stupid Love is a great song. That's all he said.
And we thought maybe he just had watched a dumb TikTok and was like, you guys are stupid. And we're like, funny.
But then he wrote that. We were like, holy shit, like, he listens to our music. It was fucking crazy. And then he went back and forth and he was like, yeah, one of my boys sent me your shit. And it just sounded like he was just like one of the boys. Like, it was just so funny. It's like one of the biggest artists in the world, just like on TikTok.
And then, yeah, to that point, like, to be able to share that with them, and, like, be on FaceTime and like that whole night be about that and just being so hype and like, it's just, it's cool. It brings you back to, like, we really, no one thought, like, obviously, maybe people believed in it when we first started it, but, like, no one expected any of it to happen. So I have to keep reminding yourself that, like, man, 15-year-old me would have been just, like, shocked that we're even
been doing this right
to
now.
Be here. Yeah, you know what I mean?
Look at this picture of 15-year-old me with Romel. I talked to you. I talked to you, too, but I think I was too nervous to ask for a picture. I wanted to seem like,
that's
I just want to
so
talk. I just want to talk.
Cute.
That's so lit.
Look at the hoodie.
Look at Romel, bro.
I know, I'm wearing his face.
It's also like someone told us recently, like, when it happens quick. And like Sora was alluding to earlier, like, we went through like a couple years now, just like not really knowing what's going on and trying to chip away at it. And like all of a sudden it just feels different. And like you're getting attention from different people, and it's like just like that. And it feels like it happened in an instant, but it's also those 2 years you spent kind of grinding it out that didn't feel directly connected, that gets you to these months of craziness.
What would you say to those people who are in those 2 years, you know, who are like in that time period?
I would say, like, everyone's going to doubt you already. Like, everyone has something to say because they always think that their opinion is the best. But the most important thing is, like, you can't doubt yourself doing it. That sounds really corny, but, like, there's been so many moments where we've tried to anticipate what any random person would have to say about something. Like, I've had the most fun when we've stuck with our gut in the sense of, like, we really believe that this is... I remember there was a song on our last album that actually we played for you, and we were like, we don't really know if it fits, but we like it, and people end up like people like to listen to it.
Was it Crazy Stupid?
Yeah, it was the one that Drake ended up liking.
You knew before Drake?
And you were like, that's one of my favorite songs of you guys. And we were like, well, it feels kind of silly, or like it's not deep enough, or it's not really about something. Like, not everything has to be like a Shakespeare sonnet. And that moment made me be like, damn, like, if it's just fun to listen to and people enjoy it and it's genuine, I can feel that feeling, like, go with that. Like, you can get so in the weeds with everything has to be perfect or mean something or have symbolism, which I think it should, but like, it shouldn't make it less fun to put out music.
I feel like when we think about the audience too, we're thinking more not like what do they want, but like what would be fun for them. Like, what can we give them that they'll enjoy, as opposed to like what are they telling us to do? Because I think as artists, it's our job to like lead them, but you also have to be aware of who you're talking to, like who are the people. What you make now is different when you make like 10 years ago.
And we love thinking about the live show. Like, even before we were playing shows, it was like, yo, this would be so sick as like the openings of the set kind of thing. When we would drop albums on Fridays and we'd go to school on Friday, that's the best feeling. We were just like,
yeah, we were so hyped.
Like, and just like, dropped an EP.
Yeah, and then to be able to like have those moments where like those kids who were into it are now like in the van with us driving to our show and like get to be part of the backstage crew, like to share that with them, as small as it is, like it's just that's my favorite part. Like, when people validate me in the sense that they're like, oh, this is what you've been doing for 7 years. Oh, I think that that's cool. And no one's like, what the fuck are you doing? Like, you should have gotten a degree in like sociology or something.
Were niggas picking on y'all because you were like chasing the dream in a way that felt super ambitious?
We were super corny about it.
Like, what
to them?
Like,
no, we just when we had 9 Instagram followers, we acted like you our roll. We yeah, rolled we out the website, first, like, we counted down the days till the album was going to drop when, like, no one, like, we were the ones commenting on our photos.
It's fire, though.
No, it is. It's okay. Fire now, but, to, right, like, Gabe from Beacon High School, man.
Oh,
it was not
Gabe,
fire. Gabe, I had to call him out. I don't know.
But no, it's
Gabe.
Funny.
Who else? Let's just do it now.
Yeah.
Gabe. Gabe's like, he's the one in my mind. He's like the visual.
The haters.
Well, he also, yeah, he stole his girl.
I don't know if that had anything to do with
it. Bro, you skipped over
yeah,
she was never his.
You brought him. Bro,
someone said on one of our videos the other day that we look like you created a player, like on Skate 3 or something. Like just mixing, matching the shirt and the pants, and it just, honestly, we're kind of humble today.
Yeah.
My style inspiration is Brad Pitt when he was dating Angelina Jolie.
Or Jennifer Aniston. Yeah.
I was like, actually, they were married.
Yeah, no. Jennifer Aniston. No, I think it's also funny, like, the band name, Laundry Day, came from, like, making fun of each other for wearing stupid outfits, like, when it looked like it was Laundry Day and we ran out of clothes. And now we kind of dress like that. Kind of reverse engineering.
We have a dream to score a movie.
Yeah,
I think that would be really fun. We've done little dibbles and dabbles in certain film things, but I think it'd be really cool to, like, get to a place where someone could be like, and Laundria does all the music.
Yeah.
All right, maybe that trip. We scored the movie that we were tonight.
There it is.
Fire.
We did the
whale. That was our first taste.
Which is fun, because, like, we've always wanted to do that, and then we were like, well, we're making a movie.
Let's go.
Yeah. This is Laundry Day, and you're watching Disney Channel.
Wait, no.
What?
You didn't watch Disney Channel?
I definitely did. Y'all didn't.
No, yeah, we did. We're not dying.
Y'all did not watch my.
Thank you guys. Sorry for being
here. Thank
you. Thank
you. You got me.